With a mentality of not being able to buy for 18 yuan and not being able to fall for it. Mr. French Fries appeared on Iwo Jima with a digital ID in the ideal scenario, one game, one player per 10 steps, and 100 kills per pro. The reality is that the customer service interface is too difficult to apply for a refund. Refund failed, opened email, was about to curse, email automatically flipped down. Soviet greetings, Comrade Tredykov, private. Due to some minor frictions in Western Europe, the Soviet Union demanded an increase in the overall military readiness level. Considering that you are a member of the elite border defense force of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, we now order you to defend the Bug River Bridge near Corden, training order number 1 for the 1st Special Motorized French Fries Brigade. Chapter 1. Floor-to-floor boxing. You are listening at novelfull.audio. With a mentality of not being able to buy for 18 yuan and not being able to fall for it. Mr. French Fries appeared on Iwo Jima with a digital ID in the ideal scenario, one game, one player per 10 steps, and 100 kills per pro. The reality is that the customer service interface is too difficult to apply for a refund. Refund failed, opened email, was about to curse, email automatically flipped down. Soviet greetings, Comrade Tredykov, private. Due to some minor frictions in Western Europe, the Soviet Union demanded an increase in the overall military readiness level. Considering that you are a member of the elite border defense force of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, we now order you to defend the Bug River Bridge near Corden, training order number 1 for the 1st Special Motorized French Fries Brigade. Mr. French Fries looked at the text appearing on his monitor with a bewildered expression, along with the countdown 3, 2, 1. Being deployed next to him, and his eyes turned black. On June 22, 1941, at 3:10 a.m., the Bug River Bridge was located approximately 18 kilometers south of Brest. Holding a 1891-30 rifle and French fries, Lord appeared at the security checkpoint at the bridgehead. A plot introduction flashed before my eyes. Due to Stalin's preconceived judgment, the Soviet-German war should have been delayed until the spring of 1942. Therefore, although a large amount of intelligence indicated that Germany was about to launch a surprise attack on the Soviet Union, Stalin only mobilized troops deep into the border to quietly crawl into the war, while emphasizing the prohibition of any actions that could cause tension among the German army and avoid creating an excuse for the German army to attack. However, at this moment, Little Beard was already loaded with bullets, and Operation Barbarossa was on the verge of firing. The Corden Bridge is one of the key locations for crossing the Bug River and launching a deep attack on Brest, to defend the Corden Bridge, so I'm Tredykov now. The French fries gentleman, who felt the weight of the real gun for the first time, lifted his rifle and instinctively pulled open the bolt to look at the yellow bullets in the barrel. Oh, really? Then he touched the RPG-33 grenade at his waist, and the cold touch also indicated that it was a real weapon. Okay, we won't win and we won't get refunds, right? Let's watch me flip my little beard. The weather has cleared and the rain has stopped. The 1 hour journey of lying dead on Iwo Jima has been forgotten. The instinctive king of war, who has been infused into his body, has taken over the high ground of consciousness. The Lord of French Fries has entered the perspective of Private Tredykov, holding up his rifle and aiming towards the forest line far from the bridge. Focus in the perspective, mini map, head up prompt, equipment bar, health bar, all appear one by one. Just like the game, isn't this just a game of cheating? The confidence of Mr. French Fries once again exploded, as if the game couldn't be defeated, and the real battlefield was enough. After a burst of left and right glances and dodges, confirming that he was using his gun like a divine body technique, the French Fries gentleman, who was about to fire 2 shots to test the water, noticed the time indicated by his head up. June 22, 41:3.14, Barbarossa. Barbarossa. I. With a loud gunshot, Mr. French Fries plunged into the ditch next to the bridge. After a series of gunshots, the world returned to tranquility. On the ground entering the death animation, the French fries lord brushed the death interface in front of him. Bid man slash 0.1 slash assault soldier, light infantry, slash MP38, it doesn't seem to hurt. Is this just a box? The French fries gentleman became decadent again. The body flipped into a dying perspective and saw a group of German soldiers rushing towards the pier of the bridge from beside them. After walking the dying line, the view disappeared. The deployment interface in the top down corner appears, indicating three occupation points. The Coden bridgehead, point A, the engineer's shelter, point B, and the border camp, point C, where the Tredykov Border Army Squadron is stationed. At this point, they have all begun to occupy the territory. The dozen or so small dots displaying our personnel have all turned into crosses. MMP, will you be salvaged wherever you go? Frustrated Mr. Potato, he didn't have time to take a closer look at the other features of the deployment interface, so he directly redeployed from the base birth point located 500 m northeast of the bridgehead, preparing to fight again. The reincarnated French fry lord appeared in a small forest, holding a rifle and burying his head to charge towards point B indicated on the mini-map. The head-up prompt displays commands to guard key areas and blow up bridges. Your French fry grandpa is back again, said the French fry lord as he slid down and flipped over the roadside barrier. He reached out and took out a sticky bomb from his four-dimensional backpack. I hope it can explode with just one throw, just like in the game. The French fries, who have not studied bridge engineering and do not know how to blast, came to mind. Approaching the border camp, Mr. Potato pounced on the grass by the roadside, "You can't see me, you can't see me." Mr. Potato, who had his head shot multiple times in the grass on Iwo Jima, could only pray while attempting to bypass the edge of the camp and head for the engineering bunker. The assault team of the German 3rd Armored Division, which had just launched a surprise attack on this area, clearly did not anticipate the possibility of further deployment. They had already followed orders and, except for leaving a few people to guide the subsequent tank troops across the bridge, all others had taken the armored vehicles that had just crossed the river and rushed towards Brest in the northeast direction. They conducted a surprise investigation and established a forward camp to prepare for a counterattack from the Soviet army in the north. After a few minutes of battling wits and bravery between the French fries lord and the air, they finally climbed to the vicinity of the engineering bunker. It seems different from the game. From the perspective of the potato chip lord, although all occupied points in the mini-map have been lost and the head-up display indicates that the area is lost, the words, "immediately retreat," are displayed, but the area is not drawn outside the battlefield, and he has not been punished for leaving the battlefield. Damn it, I lost some points in just a few minutes, didn't even see my opponent clearly. After a brief ideological struggle to decide whether to retreat, the French fry lord decided to at least throw a thunder on the bridge before leaving. Suddenly standing up from the grass, he made a lunge towards the engineering bunker and extended the trench. He bent down in the trench and suddenly heard the roar of the engine as he approached the hiding place. On Iwo Jima, he was killed multiple times by tanks and reflexively fell down again. The tanks of the 3rd Armored Division have already begun to pass through the bridge. Is bombing a bridge still meaningful now? Mr. French Fries shook his hand and pulled out a Thorn Thunder from his four-dimensional backpack. Do you want to give the cow a squeeze? I began to recall the various short videos that lured me into the pit before, and reviewed the anti-tank gymnastics movements. Just as he pulled out an anti-tank bound grenade with his other hand, preparing for the grenade, M1, and Mother Pinch Bull Triple Company. The German assault team soldiers left on the roadbed suddenly shone their flashlights on one side of the engineering bunker. The French fries lord, who had been swayed by the German soldiers, could only lean tightly against the side of the shelter, avoiding the light. Looking at the stalemate displayed on the head-up display, my heart began to tremble. They shouldn't be able to see, right? The translation system provided by the system came into play. Sergeant, what's the situation? No situation, fortunately, it seems they can't see, said the French fries lord, stuffing his grenade back into his four-dimensional backpack and touching the cold sweat that didn't exist on his head. He decided to continue crawling forward and try to blow up the bridge. After crawling and playing a game of hiding from the light for a while, the French Fry Lord finally approached the spot where he had packed the box. He quickly took out sticky explosives and threw out two pieces. Just as he was about to press the detonator, the body of Tredykov I suddenly twitched, and the instinct of the War King once again occupied the high ground. "Damn it, the explosion at the bridgehead can only create a pit, keep exploding," the French Fries cursed at themselves, and they began to think of other ways using all the explosives. "Climb up the bridge foundation to pick up explosives. Shooting to death with a random gun." Mother pinched a cow and a tank. Unable to block the bridge X, Mr. French Fries had no choice but to turn around and lean against the hidden area, temporarily avoiding the flashlight of the German soldiers. "When I turned around, I saw a sign that could be built in the grass nest near the river." At this time, the head-up prompt also showed that press T to build the detonator. "Hmm." A potato chip with a universal hammer pulled out of the air and rushed towards the river with a sliding shovel. The hammer automatically turns into a wrench, and with a few clicks, "Hurry up." At this moment, the German soldiers guarding the bridge foundation heard the sound again, and the French fries that were being constructed in place were immediately discovered. The sound of MP-38 gunfire and explosions echoed simultaneously. "Shit." Chips Lord once again enters the death animation. Bidman/0.2/assault soldier, light infantry/MP-38 immediately adjust your dying perspective and look in the direction of the bridge. Suddenly, a burst of flames erupted. "The bridge is probably broken, isn't it?" Looking up, a series of battle reports flashed through: destroy vehicle plus 100 damaged cover plus 75 damaged bridge plus 500 defensive bonus plus 300, just damaged. In the midst of the German soldiers' sharp whistles and a flurry of shouting, the dying perspective ended. Returning to the top view deployment interface again, Mr. French Fries has noticed that all spawning points are no longer usable, indicating a failed turn. Countdown to deploying again: 30. 29. Helpless Mr. French Fries began to check the various functions of its deployment interface. Chapter 2. First Shot. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The deployment interface is almost the same as the game, but due to a failed turn, there is currently no bird's-eye view of the deployment map, and one can only browse through the equipment of various branches. Although Chips Lord only has 1 hour of gaming experience, he has watched a lot of short videos with knowledge about battlefield firearms every day. I immediately realized that there were many additional Soviet weapons and equipment, including famous submachine guns such as the PPD.40 and PPSH.41, Mokenigan's rifle carbine, a member of the Dapanji family's DP light machine gun, and the Maxim heavy machine gun with wheels removed from World War I veterans. Seeing the Maxim with a water-cooled jacket and a modified handle and bipod, the French Fry King can only sigh that he is truly a battlefield superhero. He can charge with a Type 97 vehicle-mounted heavy machine gun, so he probably can hold the Maxim. In addition, there is a well-known PTRD/S anti-tank rifle that goes for medals with one shot on the left shoulder and one shot on the right shoulder, which is not a problem for Superman in the battlefield. After flipping through the equipment for a while, the deployment countdown was reset to 0, and the interface went black. Brush out new plot prompts like entering a large .scale action mode. Soviet greetings, Comrade Tredykov, Private. Due to some minor frictions in Western Europe, the Soviet Union demanded an increase in the overall military readiness level. Considering that you are a member of the elite Border Defense Force of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, we now order you to defend the near end of the Bug River, Volika Dobryanska, training order number 2 of the First Special Motorized French Fries Brigade. So it's still the Bug River. Damn it, at least one person will be killed this time. As the French Fries Lord regained his composure, he appeared at the first defensive point near the German side of Volika Dobryanska, in a wooden watchtower on the 158 highlands outside the village. Head-up display time June 22nd, 41:3.10, it seems that I still have some time superpower, able to repeatedly jump across the time flow. Returning to the French fries Lord 5 minutes before the German attack, after a brief moment of contemplation, I immediately restrained my mind and reached out to the watchtower gun rack to pick up my rifle while warning in the direction of the expected German appearance. Damn it, I forgot to change my gun just thinking about deploying. I had no choice but to raise my rifle and aim towards the grass in front of the forest line in the distance. It was pitch black all around, and the sound of frogs could be heard not far away. How about sending a signal flare? The player's mindset remained the same, and after 2 minutes of glancing, his thoughts began to diverge. I pulled out a signal gun from Superman's magical pocket in the battlefield. Is it just like in the game? At the same time, not far away, the German assault team leader was setting the time, while signing to instruct others to remain silent and covering them with a rain cloth to block the light, using a flashlight to watch. Suddenly, with a muffled bang, a red signal flare pierced through the night sky, scattering a small umbrella with a red light ball and falling towards the German assault team's hideout. A small bright light simultaneously alarmed the troops on both sides of the Bug River. On the Soviet side, the drowsiness of the sentinels standing guard in the early morning was dispelled by a shock, and they were lost in thought. On the German side, as soon as he finished reading the watch, he realized that the German lieutenant he might have exposed was hesitating in taking action. However, time did not give both sides a chance to continue hesitating. Mr. French Fries sent a freehand signal, as if giving orders to the German artillery group. The dance of hell began, and the ground trembled. Countless rockets flew over the Bug River and smashed into the fortress and town of Brest. During this period, there was a mix of the roar of 210mm heavy artillery and 600mm heavy mortar. Sleeping slot, I didn't call the area cannon, did I? Chips Lord's backpack was replaced by a battlefield magic walkie-talkie, and a large Ivan call phone appeared in his hand. Time didn't give Mr. French Fries any time to be shocked. The sound of artillery was an attack signal. The German assault team had already rushed to the watchtower within more than 10 seconds of Mr. French Fries being stunned, and the engineers directly exploded with explosives. The sound of explosives exploding was drowned out amidst the sound of thousands of cannons, and the French Fry Lord entered the interface of death. Bidman/0.3/support force, engineer/adhesive explosives, damn it, another TM shot didn't fire. This time, the French Fries gentleman, who was sitting on a dirt plane, didn't even return to the birds. I deployment interface from a near-death perspective. The abandoned watchtower, point A, where he was originally located has been displayed as occupied. The customs stronghold, point B, on the bridge over the Bug River has also begun to shift towards a dispute zone. With a sudden change of mind, the potato chip lord transformed from an initial reconnaissance soldier to a support soldier, appeared at the extension of the Soviet air defense trench on the Bug River, carrying a Maxim 1910-30 machine gun, and then charged towards the customs stronghold. The sound of gunfire also awakened the Soviet border troops stationed at the customs. But the border troops, who were not fully prepared for battle, only a few scattered rifles began to fire at the German elite who had already crossed the railway bridge and launched an attack on the customs stronghold, point B, and were soon silenced by the German machine gun group who had already taken advantage of the position. The engineering battalions of the Soviet Ministry of Internal Affairs stationed here were not even equipped with weapons, and were only dispatched to strengthen the new national defense line. At this time, most of them were walking on distant construction sites. Only the second lieutenant officers of the engineering team who have plans to blow up the bridge in the event of an attack are left to be indecisive about whether to blow up the bridge. Time has not yet given the second lieutenant, who lacks subjective initiative after the major cleaned up, the decision to act directly without command, and the muzzle of the German assault team has already pointed to the second lieutenant's head. At this moment, Chips June is still rushing over. Although it is effortless to lift Maxim, the game's faithful weight setting still slows down his running speed. In addition, the explosion of artillery behind him occasionally flips Chip's Jun over, and it takes a few minutes to maneuver and enter the reserve shooting position in the air defense trench. Immediately lie down and mount a gun, regardless of aiming, and fire in the direction of the custom stronghold, point B, that has already been displayed as occupied. I hope to suppress invisible enemies like in the game, said Mr. Fries, using his shallow practical experience to comfort his reckless shooting behavior. After the machine gun bullets flew out of the view of the French Fries Lord, they regained their realistic attributes and did not faithfully suppress invisible enemies like in the game. They only landed far away from the German assault team continuing to attack, without any accuracy. The German assault team, which had already planned for this, immediately used machine guns to suppress the direction of the French Fries Lord, and followed closely with the engineering obstacle breaking team to attack the direction of the air defense trench. The French Fry Lord, suppressed by a string of bullets, struggled to crawl towards the shelter. Damn it, isn't it realistic? Just like in the game, you can only lie down and pan, not roll directly. When he regained his composure, Mr. French Fries took out a panacea and pressed it onto his body. He then mounted his gun again and crawled forward, ready to continue outputting. At the end of time, there was no chance for the French Fries Lord to hit the enemy, and the German engineering team had already arrived. With a loud bang, the French Fries King, who had flown two dirt planes in 5 minutes, entered the death zone again. Bidman/0.4/support force, engineer/adhesive explosives, ah. The French Fry Lord, who was once again bombarded by a close-range explosion, entered the Bird's Eye deployment interface with blank eyes. Watching the Soviet Union's last border defense camp, point C, enter an occupation state. This time, Mr. French Fries didn't have a chance to regroup and deployed at the base's birth point. Join forces with the German army in another battle. The deployment interface has gone black, indicating a failed turn. The countdown to deploying again is 30. 29. Chapter 3. First Blood. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Damn it, I thought I was hitting someone with a hook, but I didn't expect to be hit by someone with a hook from the opposite side, sighed the French Fries gentleman, who had recovered from his airplane state. To be fair, the German infantry of 41 years old were the elite of 100 battles, sweeping through Western Europe without a single defeat. They had not yet been sharpened by the resilience of the Soviet Union and the cold winter of Moscow, and were even more advanced than the battlefield pro brothers. During the beginning of the Barbarossa campaign, the little Karami like the Chips Lord could only learn how to fight with his life, just like the Soviet infantry who had just undergone a major purge and had been shaken during the military reform. Gone, where are your teammates? However, the still game-oriented French Fries gentleman didn't think so and began to blame his teammates for coming. Recalling his painful experience of being crushed on the beach for 30 minutes, how could these people be even worse than me, tanks, planes, and cannons? Mr. Chips began to check the deployment interface around, trying to find the vehicle deployment button, but in response, he silently walked to zero before deploying the countdown. The interface is black. Brush out new plot prompts again. Soviet greetings, Comrade Tredykov, Private. Due to some minor frictions in Western Europe, the Soviet Union demanded an increase in the overall military readiness level. Considering that you are a member of the elite Border Defense Force of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, we now order you to defend the far end of the Bug River, a section of the Plata Forest that is easy to bridge, training order number 3 of the 1st Special Motorized French Fries Brigade. It's the Bug River again, how are you going to ambush me this time? The French Fries Lord, still holding the Maxim 1910-30 machine gun, refreshed on the Soviet side of the Bug River, patrolling the Soviet border patrol as usual. More than 10 Soviet soldiers, armed with PPD submachine guns and carrying DP light machine guns on their shoulders, marched in columns on the small path behind the small forest by the riverbank. The French Fries gentleman who appeared behind the queue and was looking left and right was immediately discovered by the patrol team captain. Tredykov, if you don't immediately follow the queue, I will report to the political commissar and ask him to confirm if your belongings need to be sent to Gulag. The Soviet sergeant, implanted in his memory, warned the French Fry Lord. Yes. Comrade Sergeant, replied Tredykov conditionally in the body of the French Fry's gentleman. The Germans are coming. The French Fry's Lord reoccupied the highlands. Be on guard. After speaking, Mr. French Fry's disregarded a slide and shoveled down the path, placing Maxim on a small mound of soil and looking across the river. I took a distracted glance and looked up to prompt. Time. June 22, 2021 3.10 Sure enough, it's time for the sudden attack again. Mr. French Fries, keep up your spirits and make sure to hit people this time. What are you joking about? Didn't the Germans sign a contract with us? Today, Comrade Lieutenant also informed us not to shoot and not to cause dissatisfaction among the Germans and go to war. The sergeant retorted, dismissive. Did you steal vodka today? Comrades from the political commissar prohibit us from drinking before patrolling. Another soldier who seemed to be familiar with Tredykov also asked in response. The French Fries gentleman, who was focused on accuracy, ignored these remarks. Carefully observed the water plants across the river, as if trying to dig out Germans from inside. The sergeant was a bit angry when he saw that the French Fries Lord was not moving. Comrade Tredykov, this is an order. Follow the cue, don't imagine you're Germans. Then the sergeant gestured for the two soldiers to turn back and pull the French Fries Lord. However, just as the two soldiers had just arrived at the spot where Chip's Lord was lying down, ready to kick his butt dada-dada, the French Fries Lord opened fire, and then the sound of light machine guns retaliating came from across the river. Two soldiers who were preparing to kick the French Fries Lord were swept down. Enemy attack. The sergeant, who was originally planning to make fun of the French Fry Lord, reacted quickly even though he was just teasing. Spread out, fight back, Boris, go see Joseph and Alexei. The entire team quickly transformed into a combat formation, leaving the path and crawling around the small forest, beginning to occupy favorable terrain to counterattack. The medical soldier named Boris crawled towards the two Soviet soldiers who had just been swept down. On the other side of the river, the German assault captain was very angry about the sudden opening of fire across the river. Hans, what are you investigating? Didn't you say that the Soviet patrol team should have left here 10 minutes ago? Let the machine gun team fire, we must immediately take down the bridgehead. Then the assault captain pushed the small kayak hidden in the water grass down the river, flipped over and began to cross the Bug River. Several G-42 flames swept across the river. The Germans, who had long planned, had much stronger firepower than Soviet patrol teams. Although the border troops had a high proportion of Soviet elite submachine guns and light machine guns, they were quickly suppressed by the German army. Tredykov, I command you to immediately notify Captain Alexander and ask him to warn the 333rd Regiment that the Germans have launched a surprise attack. As soon as he realized that the enemy was not just provoking but also attacking, the sergeant immediately issued a new order. However, the German firepower suppressed the operation of the French Fries Lord. In an area without sufficient cover, 12 soldiers of the patrol team were quickly killed and severely injured. Only the first to lie down and find a favorable position in advance is the French Fries Lord, who can continue the battle with the help of a panacea. However, the experienced French Fries Lord has decided to temporarily die this time. Prepare to wait for the German assault team on the river to cross the Bug River, which is several tens of meters wide, and then close to the riverbank before firing. With a distance of 10 yards and accuracy, the French Fries gentleman thinks they can definitely make a big profit. As for the orders of the sergeant, am I familiar with him? It can't affect me fishing for French fries. The French Fries King thought of it. Quickly, after the weak counterattack from the Soviet Union was suppressed by light machine guns, the German assault team successfully landed. The assault team leader gestured to command a group of people to rush towards the small forest where the Soviet patrol team counterattacked, inspecting the battlefield, while leading the remaining personnel to investigate in the planned direction. After the German army across the river saw the successful landing of the assault team, the engineering team immediately pushed the prepared small boat, carrying supplies to cross the river and prepare to build a floating bridge for the subsequent troops. At the same time, several other assault teams crossing the river nearby also successfully landed and began excavating their positions, preparing to resist the Soviet counterattack. A bridgehead was established. The French Fries King, who was lying motionless, watched as the progress bar on the riverbank, point A, in the mini-map had already turned around, leaving only a little blue representing himself to prevent the position from being occupied. And all 12 points representing my temporary teammates have become forks. Gone, come a little closer, Mr. French Fries looked at the German assault team moving forward and pulled the trigger. The heavy sound of Dada Maxim rang out, and the front German soldier fell to the ground in response. Mr. French Fries, the head-up display will flash out kill plus 100 defensive kill plus 150, hit. Just as he was about to turn his gun and shoot at another German soldier, Chips June was immediately overwhelmed by the bullets from the MP38. Once again entering the death screen, the French Fry King didn't know whether to laugh or cry. One plant, just one caught, bid man slash 1.5 slash assault soldier, light infantry, slash MP38. Chapter 4. Submarine Landing. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The urgently redeployed French Fries quickly skipped the near-death perspective. I've been holding on for quite a long time this time. Returning to the deployment interface overlooking the map, Mr. Potato noticed that although the riverbank position, point A, and the depth cover trench, point B, marked on the map have already been occupied, there are still blue dots representing friendly forces at the outpost, point C, and even support coming from the direction of the rear base's berth point. Hey, your French Fries grandpa is here again. Considering that the last time Maxim's support speed was slow and he suffered losses, he carried a PPD submachine gun and redeployed it on the outskirts of the outpost, point C. With a slide shovel, he lay down directly and glanced at the intense gunfire, feeling lingering fear. This posture doesn't seem to require me to warn the captain anymore. I'll just go and be the sixth. Of course, it's not because I'm afraid of the Germans' marksmanship, thought the French Fries gentleman, changing direction and circling towards the spot where he died in the small forest by the river. In the darkness, various flames spewed out, and the German vanguard troops engaged in fierce exchanges with the Soviet Ministry of Internal Affairs Border Guard's 9th outpost stationed here. After being awakened by German artillery fire, the 333rd Infantry Regiment guarding Brest in the rear was busy and unable to form a complete organization. However, one of the most vigilant company leaders still sent two teams to support the border troops nailed to the Huen Heights. For a while, the battle for the bridgehead intensified. Although the Germans were somewhat angered by the sudden attack being broken by a reckless French Fries lord and turned into a strong attack, they still carried out their plan in an orderly manner. After the bridgehead troops called for fire support, in addition to the previously prepared light machine guns and artillery, another prepared secret weapon sailed into the Bug River towards the Soviet position. This secret weapon is the 3-tank F-type, which Little Beard had previously planned to attack the British mainland. A diving tank modified with a long ventilation pipe and sealed with inflatable rubber parts, capable of traveling in water like a U-boat. These tanks, which were originally designed to infiltrate the English Channel, crossed the Bug River at its deepest depth of only 4 meters very easily. Soon, the vanguard tanks charged up to the riverbank at full power, and the crew quickly inflated the exhaust components and threw them into battle. The Soviet army stationed here seemed quite powerless in this regard. As a border defense force with functions similar to customs, although they were all elite infantry selected by the Ministry of Internal Affairs, they were ultimately only light infantry. The heaviest weapons in their hands were only a few old armored reconnaissance vehicles, which were quickly destroyed by the 37mm guns of the Type 3 Tank F. The machine gun support points of the entire Huen Highland garrison were also named one by high explosive shells. Extremely shocked, German tanks descended from the sky, but the helpless border troops had no choice but to withdraw towards Brest town. At this moment, in order not to be discovered, I scared myself, causing the French Fries Lord, who had been circling for a long time but had not yet reached the designated location, to inexplicably see that the occupation point in the mini-map was lost, and several small blue dots representing friendly forces withdrew towards the direction of the base's resurrection point. The head-up display prompt area has been lost, please evacuate. Gone, I thought I was an elite teammate this time. Why didn't I lose some points in a while? Fortunately, there seems to be a second area left this time. Let's go back and have a vote for him. After making the decision, Chips June immediately gave up the plan to continue the detour and headed straight towards the riverbank position, point A, marked on the small map. The German vanguard, who had thoroughly cleared the border outpost on the other end, did not stop for a moment and sprinted towards Brest, ready to participate in the planned siege of Brest Fortress. There are only a small number of security forces left on the riverbank, engineering teams building bridges, and follow-up diving tanks crossing the river one after another. For these ignorant French fries, while paying attention to the distance on the mini-map, he pulled out an impact grenade from his four-dimensional backpack and prepared to launch a wave of grenades to clear the way. 100 m, the French fries gentleman bent down and walked around the forest, 50 m, 45 degrees elevation, 45 m casually throwing thunder, fire in the hole, the French fries gentleman who dubbed himself rushed up a small earthen slope by the riverbank. Bang, the grenade thrown into the river by the French fries lord followed suit and exploded faithfully, splashing water and disturbing the engineers and experts who were setting up the floating bridge. The remaining German assault team began to alert and shoot in the speculated direction of the attack. The three tank, which had just crossed the river and had leaked its turret, also turned its turret around to guard. This scene was enhanced by the system, and the night view was almost as vivid as that of the day. Sleeping in the trough, not talking about martial arts, the submarine has landed. The French fries gentleman tilted his body in a smooth sliding shovel pounced on the nearby dirt ditch, lying down motionless. After a few shots, the German security forces who did not see any counterattacks immediately launched a search around, and the three tank in the river immediately increased its power and rushed up to the riverbank, showing a defensive posture facing outward. Upon hearing some movement moving in his direction, the temporarily stunned French fries gentleman began to brush his mind with the expert video he had watched before. What should I do? What should I do? Shooting a tank won't lose blood. Gone, let's fight. The French fry lord regained his composure and stuffed the anti-tank bound grenade he had taken out of his four-dimensional backpack when he instinctively occupied the high ground by the army king Tredykov back into his bag. Put down the magical walkie-talkie, Rebirth Beacon Edition, on your back and cover it with grass. Then he suddenly stood up and slid a shovel towards one side, then ran and opened fire on the German soldiers who were searching. Come and chase me, Cheerla, I don't know that the system only arranged for German listening and translation, but did not arrange for simultaneous interpretation. The French fries lord, who thought he was right, mocked the German army, hoping to lead them away from where he hid the beacon of rebirth. The German soldiers couldn't understand the noise of the French fries lord, and only found this Soviet soldier who swayed left and right and occasionally slid his shovel funny. With the help of his marksmanship, he was able to hit the genie. Then he made a sudden stop, and the MP38 shot and sent the French fries lord into the death zone. I didn't hit it again, gone, why did I say it again? Chips June looked at the death screen, but didn't notice that he looked up and showed a prompt to hit. Bidman/1.6/assault soldier, light infantry, /MP38 staring at the German soldier who had killed him from a dying perspective, he approached and examined the body. Returning to the bird's-eye deployment interface, Chips Lord's mind moved and he said, come again, vehicle destroyer activated. Chips Lord changed his profession, shouldered the German iron fist, and redeployed it to the newly hidden rebirth beacon. Lie down and look around, it seems that the Germans haven't discovered my secret weapon. The French fries gentleman, who was reviewing anti-tank gymnastics in his mind, stood up suddenly. The sound of shouting, "Beg Barbie to pinch the cow," rushed down the slope towards the tank position on the riverbank, which had just been released from alert and was preparing to regroup for assault. At a distance of 100 meters, German soldiers who triggered the alert continuously for a short time were startled by strange screams, and their reaction slowed down by half a beat. They did not shoot and kill the French Fry King in a timely manner, allowing his iron fist to be successfully launched. However, the overly excited French Fry King successfully shot it away. At 60 meters, the four-dimensional backpack exerted force and grabbed the anti-tank-bound grenade out of thin air, throwing it with all its might. Although Chips Lord misjudged the tank's distance, Battlefield Superman still successfully threw the overweight grenade over 50 meters off the riverbank and rolled towards the newly landed tank by the river. At 40 meters, Mr. French Fries slid his shovel and flashed past the gunshots of German soldiers, while patting himself with a panacea. At 20 meters, realizing that he had miscalculated the distance, the Frenchman could only grit his head and shout again, begging Barbie to pinch the cow. The four-dimensional backpack directly summoned Thunderbolt in the Frenchman's hand, and the musket charged. Battlefield Superman bolt possessed and rushed past a group of German soldiers who were strafing towards French Fries but failed to hit, and were forced to stop shooting due to approaching their own personnel. The German tank commander, who noticed something was wrong, finally pulled out his gun from the turret and shouted for the driver to reverse, while starting to shoot at Mr. French Fries. Two explosions occurred one after another, and the newly landed Type 3 tank was scrapped in the flames. Chapter 5, I Want Another Bottle. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The explosion of Tank 3 not only knocked down the surrounding German soldiers, but also harvested the last health of the French Fries Lord. The French Fry Lord, who entered the death screen again, wore a smiling face this time. Huh, it's great. The first successful charge of French Fries, just like all successful trekking and killing tanks in the battlefield, was very excited. I didn't pay attention to it. The prompt displayed on the death screen was accidental death, and the head-up display showed a brush destroy vehicle plus 100 attack kill plus 150 hit plus 37 hit plus 39. I just want to deploy it again on the rebirth beacon and prepare for another bottle. However, the redeployment of CD time prevented French Fries from being immediately reborn. Just as French Fries watched the deployment button count down 4, 3, the German soldiers on the outskirts of the riverbank were in an indescribable state of shock. These elite generals who have swept across Europe but have not yet seen the little day-style battles, feel for the first time that there is something I have never seen before. Alert, expand the perimeter, Hans. I will report to the major at dawn and send you to bake bread. You are not suitable to stay in the reconnaissance camp. The German assault team lieutenant, with a larger heart, also reacted after being shocked for 0.114514 seconds. Immediately interrupted the others who were thinking, what haven't I seen before? I've never seen a German soldier with an emoji before, starting to command a counterattack. Yes. Hans, who was interrupted from casting, waved his hand and led the German soldiers who had just flipped up from their four-legged state to search for the outskirts. And just now, the first wave of German soldiers who were lured by the Lord of French Fries and went in the wrong direction for search were also awakened by the sound of explosions, and they came back to their senses. I didn't expect the Soviet Joker to play tricks and leave, said the German soldier who had just killed Tredykov number 6, immediately leading someone back to search in the opposite direction. Your French Fry Grandpa is here again, finally finishing the countdown, and immediately carrying a thunderbolt, the French Fry Lord rushed to the battlefield and charged again. Before the slogan, Chababi, could be finished, it was discovered by German soldiers who were sandwiched before and after, and was sent back to the death interface by random guns. The simple hidden rebirth beacon also failed after being hit by two stray bullets. Gone, do you want to be so unlucky? As he watched the statistics of the casualties, Mr. French Fries began to curse. Bidman slash 1.7 slash assault soldier, light infantry, slash MP38, I reacted too quickly, I entered a dying perspective and looked at the German soldiers approaching from two directions. I began to complain, why do the big shots in the short video seem like no one has seen them, and they can make a lot of money? The birds that I deployment interface was black screen, and the remaining soldiers of the border troops at the 9th outpost and two infantry squadrons supported by Brest cooperated to seize the brief gap in the German river crossing position disturbed by the French Fries Lord. At the time when the German vanguard had to pause the attack to confirm the safety of the bridgehead, they successfully evacuated from the River Bay Highlands. Of course, this also led to the failure of the French Fries King in this round once again. The countdown to deploying again is 30. 29, reappearing. And at the time when the French Fries Lord was slandering the German soldiers with a glance behind their heads. The incident at the riverbank position has been reported by the German messenger. The commander of the German 18th Armored Division, who was preparing to cross the river and command an assault, was moving towards the riverbank. After learning about the situation, feeling shocked and unbelievable, he instructed a staff officer to investigate the matter. And this staff officer reported in a report 1 week after the start of Operation Barbarossa that although many Soviet soldiers were not yet ready for war, lacked weapons and ammunition, and lacked the courage to fight, there were still some well-trained Soviet soldiers who fought with fanatical bravery. They believe that sacrificing themselves is completely correct, as it can buy time for their superiors and create conditions for the restructuring and breakout of the troops. This ruthless sacrifice of a small group of troops to save the majority of the troops has been repeated since the German army launched surprise attacks, and the almost suicidal attacks carried out in this way have also caused serious casualties to the German army. In this section of the report, the staff officer cited Hahn's memories of the attack on the bridgehead by the French Fries Lord. At first, we thought that Soviet soldiers were foolish and blind. They would only stick to the discovered firepower points, launch a crazy counterattack, and never pay attention to the facts they had already exposed. But soon several Soviet soldiers, with a religious fanaticism like action and tactical deception achieved through self-sacrifice, taught us a lesson to be proud. I must admit that when I first saw Soviet soldiers screaming and carrying some kind of explosive bag, ignoring bullets, charging towards my defensive line and the tank behind me, I was scared. Although the Soviet soldier seemed to have poor training, inaccurate bombing, and mistakenly used some kind of explosive device, his courage ultimately intimidated us. He successfully destroyed a Type 3 tank and also injured several of us. For this purpose, the captain of the reconnaissance battalion has developed a new night surveillance plan, expanded our surveillance range, and strictly ordered us not to be attracted by individual enemy soldiers and to narrow down the search direction. The next morning, we also attempted to locate the weapon used by the soldier who successfully attacked us, in order to take precautions in future battles. Unfortunately, we searched through the places where the last Soviet soldier was killed and were unable to find the explosive device they used. The captain speculated that these brave soldiers may have already thrown all their remaining weapons into the Bug River and destroyed them when they decided to sacrifice themselves. The countdown to redeployment has ended once again. The interface is black and new plot prompts are displayed. Soviet greetings, Comrade Tredykov, Private. Due to some minor border conflicts, the Soviet Union demanded that the entire army counterattack and repel the German provocation. Considering that you are a member of the elite border defense force of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, we now order you to defend the deep position in the direction of Corden, prevent the German Central Group Army from attacking towards the Muckowitz River Koblin direction, and ensure the flank safety of the Brest area. Training order number 4 of the 1st Special Motorized French Fries Brigade. Isn't it a river? It seems that the frontline positions have been lost. Recovered from the rapid response to German soldiers, not like the son of man's roast. Chip's Lord once again carried a PPD submachine gun and deployed it at a partially completed Soviet defense position a few kilometers east of the original Zenko Dengqiao base. With his level of military enthusiast, he chewed on the information revealed in the plot prompts. The plot prompt is refreshed again. Due to the heroic attempts of the border defense forces, the Corden Bridge was briefly interrupted by explosive attacks after being raided and taken by the German army, interrupting the assault plan of the German 3rd Armored Division. We bought a little time for the Soviet troops planning to stay here to enter the position. Despite their lack of equipment and ammunition, their valuable time allowed the defenders to successfully recruit labor camps scattered throughout the depth that were still under construction, forming a perhaps less powerful reserve team, ready to carry out a counterattack against the German vanguard as planned. So this time it's an attack. The new plot suggests that on the one hand, the French Fries King has gained some understanding of the lack of Soviet border defense. No wonder my previous teammates didn't have enough emotions even with bullets. On the other hand, I am also a bit confused. Why counterattack with incomplete TM weapons? How can we win? However, after all, the game mentality still dominates, and coupled with the recent explosion of a tank, the speed of light in the back was selectively ignored, the excited Chips Lord quickly regained his fighting spirit. Gone is done. He buries his head and rushes towards the rebirth point of the base on the side of Corden Bridge, which has become a competition point again on the map. At the moment when the French Fries Lord was once again stuck. A labor camp consisting mainly of Mongolian and Kazakh ethnic groups, which has just been partially assembled, is collecting rifles from a temporary field warehouse. The border troops stationed here will gather all the weapons they can gather here and distribute them to the workers who have just put down their engineering shovels and look dull. Matrosov, have you returned from the messenger of the other units of the 5th Army Group? Asked the Soviet border guard captain anxiously, who was commanding the distribution of weapons. Report to Comrade Captain, there is none. Comrade Romanovich, we must immediately launch a counterattack according to the plan, recapture the bridgehead, and cover the attack of subsequent troops. Said the Border Defense Political Commissar, who was staring at the map on the side. Comrade Bujoni, I know the plan, but we only have so many people now and we don't have enough weapons. There is no news of the 312 ND regiment that was originally planned to attack with us. Are you saying that you have lost the courage to fight? Do you need me to send you to Gulag on the charge of cowardice? The helpless Soviet captain could only signal the soldiers on the side who were preparing to carry guns to stop moving. Arrange for Ivan to lead the 3rd team and hold on to this place, while the others follow me to the 178 heights. Comrade Bujoni, please wait here for the news of my victory. No, I will lead these newly recruited soldiers to participate in this attack. Chapter 6. The Coordination of Yin and Yang Errors. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The Soviet captain led the remaining half of the border defense team, consisting of over 30 people, who had retreated from the front line of Corden. Before dawn, they once again touched the original stationed outpost, under a small hill overlooking the Corden Bridge. 3 hours ago, they were attacked by the German army here, and were outnumbered and forced to evacuate. But just as the German army occupied the outpost, they were able to pursue and annihilate them. The explosion created by the French Fries Lord at the distant Corden Bridge bought them time. Finally, they were able to retreat to the defense fortifications originally planned to be assigned to the field army in the depths of the Corden Column after the battle alarm was sounded. And what was despairing was that when they arrived at this unfinished position, the Soviet field army, which was theoretically supposed to be deployed, did not appear, only the labor camp still under construction. Fortunately, the Soviet captain and political commissar still maintained their fighting spirit, and this remaining army inspected the entire position on the spot. The anti-tank fortifications have not been fully completed, and there are no anti-tank guns in the 5-gun positions. The machine gun bunkers have not been fully capped. There are only various trenches and traffic trenches that have just been dug and not reinforced, and the defensive positions in this state have not even received shells in the previous German firepower preparation. The situation can be said to be very, even 9% worse. After finding, catching, the labor camp commander who had been hiding in the forest behind the position during the previous firepower preparation, the border captain finally learned that the station troops here had received orders from their superiors 2 days ago to retreat to the rear training ground and prepare to receive new weapons. Now, only two unfinished anti-tank guns and some old Moshenigan rifles that were about to be phased out remain in the temporary field warehouse of the position, and the pitiful lack of ammunition reserves for a base. As a last resort, the border guard captain and political commissar of the labor camp stationed here could only be forcibly recruited, leading to a previous argument. "Captain, are we really going to counterattack?" asked Sergeant Matlasov, the patrol captain of the border army, who was one of the first to engage with the German army and knew that they had tank support. "That's right, it's not just because of that damn order. We only have two legs and can't beat tanks just by running. At least we need to regain the outpost, or buy some more time for the laborers who reorganize the defense fortifications to reinforce the fortifications. Perhaps we still have hope to persist until the higher platoon provides support." The captain, who was observing the German army on the hillside with a telescope, knew that the entire army was currently restless, and for the first time, he specifically explained his own thoughts. "Perhaps the political commissar is a bit rigid, but he is right. Only by maintaining our current position can we have the possibility of winning." "Yes, comrade captain," at the Soviet border guard political commissar's rectification of the labor camp, the border guard captain led the remaining troops to plan a counter-attack on the German advance position. At the same time, the French Fries Lord also bypassed the original base's rebirth point and, before the first glimmer of light in the sky, retouched the air defense trench, point B, outside the Kadenkyo border checkpoint. It has to be said that the success of this flanking operation has nothing to do with the tactical level of the French Fries Lord, and it basically relies on the help of the German army. The French Fries Lord happened to be deployed inside the German perimeter guard position and in the secondary assault direction of the German army. The 3rd Armored Division, which had been delayed by the bridge explosion during the raid for nearly 3 hours, was busy re-planning the assault plan and focused all its attention on the possible direction of Soviet counterattack discovered during reconnaissance. "The main tank regiment of the division is ready to step on the accelerator to recover the wasted 3 hours. The order given by Lieutenant General Weddle is to continue the assault at the fastest speed, as the division's destination today is Koblin on the Mukhovets River, which is nearly 75 kilometers away from Koden in a straight line. Grandma's grand scene." Listening to the roar of numerous tanks, the French Fries King, who was lying in a shelter in the air defense trench, had some claws, and the Germans were also very fast. After taking a look at the time displayed on the head-up display, which was just 6.10, although the geography knowledge was basically returned to the teacher, the French Fries gentleman who clearly felt the brightness change in the field of view, in fact, the system was adjusting the brightness filter for time changes, also knew that dawn was coming soon. "At night, I was beaten like a duck by German soldiers. How about it when it's dawn? If you don't want to take a look anymore, can the previous detonator still be used?" Mr. Fries thought to himself, but then he denied himself. "With the speed at which the Germans cleared my resurrection point before, I probably won't be able to get close to the bridge. What should we do?" Mr. French Fries found over a dozen small blue dots on the outskirts of the border camp, point C, in the mini-map. "Although I don't know if this is the faint team in the Soviet captain's planned surprise attack plan." But Chips Lord felt like he had received friendly support for the first time and decided to help the farm. "Touch out an impact grenade." "Done." Mr. French Fries reached for the extended traffic trench of the air defense trench and before jumping out, he flicked the rebirth beacon on his back. "Oula." The French Fries Lord began to pounce, perhaps because this absurd appearance had a deterrent effect on the German army, or perhaps because his position was too incredible. The German army, which was mainly on guard ahead, did not respond to the charge launched by the French Fries Lord alone. Until the French Fry Lord specifically aimed at the thrown impact grenade and it fell into the trench outside the border camp, with a loud bang, although it didn't explode anything. But like a doorbell, it officially notified the German machine gun team to start shooting towards the direction of the Soviet surprise attack. The Soviet feint team, who didn't have time to curse and didn't know who had exposed their own whereabouts, had no choice but to fire back while covering each other and retreating towards the previously concealed area. Seeing little blue dot retreating instead of advancing, I didn't know that I had broken someone else's plan, so I could only curse while pulling out a grenade launcher and firing towards the Soviet machine gun position just now. I roughly fired in the direction before sliding and charging towards that side. "Your French fry grandpa is here," he rushed into the trench, grabbed the trigger, and fired a volley, successfully catching a German soldier who was startled by the sudden appearance of the French fry lord. Kill plus 100 attack, kill plus 150 while changing ammunition, complaining about the reality of only being able to throw one mine, just like in the game. So far, I have not paid attention to any supply points, and I hope for a supply point for the first time. After repelling the front Soviet feint group, German soldiers who had already been touched by the enemy immediately surrounded them in the direction of gunfire, and sharp whistles sounded everywhere. "Damn it, we're surrounded." The enemy is not displayed on the mini-map, but it doesn't affect the judgment made by Mr. Potato. "I hope you haven't found my rebirth beacon." Taking out the grenade launcher again, Mr. French Fries jumped out of the trench and said, "Your grandfather is here." A grenade fired directly at two German soldiers who were closer in distance. Kill plus 100 attack, kill plus 150 double kill plus 100 hit plus 98, then the gunfire of MP38 rang out. French Fry Lord enters the death screen. Bidman slash 3.8 slash assault soldier, light infantry, slash MP38 number 34, this time it's not a loss. The Soviet feint team, which had withdrawn from its hiding place, found that German positions were exploding one after another. "Are you a comrade who got separated before? We'll go back again." "Yes, the captain's feint mission has not been completed yet." So more than 10 people launched another attack on the front position of the border camp. The captain of the Border Defense Army, who made the same judgment, also led the main attack team originally scheduled to attack at dawn with the advantage of light, changed the plan, abandoned detours, and directly penetrated the border positions. So on the brink of death interface, I was originally planning to observe the French Fries Lord stationed by the German army. I only noticed that nearly 30 small blue dots in the mini-map moved towards me and quickly crossed a few. "Are you here to save me?" I didn't know that these Soviet soldiers couldn't see the mini-map, but rather relied solely on the explosion to make a judgment. The French Fries gentleman ended his near-death perspective with a touch of emotion. Chapter 7. Some people don't speak of martial virtue. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The Soviet border defense team's counterattack successfully left the German army, who had been distracted by the French Fries Lord, temporarily confused. I did not find the rebirth beacon that was casually discarded by Mr. French Fries at the end of the air defense trench, giving him a chance to have another one. "Brothers, hold on, this wave is bigger than Lao Ba's." The roaring French Fry King couldn't wait for a second on the birds that I deployment interface. As soon as the countdown ended, a handheld Maxim descended from the sky. Like a standing Taisway, holding a compassionate Maxim, the autumn wind sweeps the fallen leaves. Although there is no snowflake, it makes the German army's spine feel like 3 or 9. The hit prompt is displayed by swiping the screen and looking up. Thanks to the great power of the French Fries Lord, the Soviet border defense team, which had already lost more than 10 people under the German firepower, had already shown a weak momentum. Transformed into Ula Superman, wearing an invincible sea soul shirt, the summer rain drove away passers-by. Although it was June with no roots, it made the German army's heads seem like they were in a cloud. In a tug of war, a German armored reconnaissance battalion, which was about to withdraw 5 minutes ago and was chasing the tank regiment, turned into a ground. And just now, the vanguard of another tank regiment of the 3rd Armored Division, who urgently reinforced the Corden Bridge with engineers, finally realized that the situation was not right. "Isn't it true that the vanguard regiment has already run over this area, and only the scattered Soviet guerrillas here need to wait for the armored grenadier regiment to follow up and consolidate their flank. How does it feel like the main force of Soviet infantry is counterattacking? This must be praised, the battlefield super weapon handheld heavy machine gun that will never overheat. There is also the forever unknown battle universal ammunition box that was thrown under the feet of the French Fries Lord. The sound of shots from Mr. French Fries pulling the trigger without letting go was far more intense than the heavy machine guns from a Soviet artillery battalion. However, there was ultimately no roar from a single cannon. The German tank battalion commander, who had crossed the river first, clenched his fist and swung three times towards the 178 high ground of the border guard post. Tank attack. Full of fuel and ammunition, it has been accumulating strength for 3 hours at the departure position. Originally intended as a direct support force for the Vanguard Armored Reconnaissance Battalion, 12 new Type 4 tanks, which were supposed to assist in breaking through the Soviet fortress, quickly drove off the road and formed a combat formation. With a mentality of killing chickens with knives, they surrounded the Soviet border outpost. While the French Fries Lord was still in the shape of a Stallone, sweeping trenches one by one, and the Soviet border guard advancing into the German front, the two sides had not yet met. The 75mm gun of tank IV fired and the Soviet captain at the forefront was overturned, causing a delay in the forward Soviet attack. The border defense team, fearing nothing, had no anti-tank capability and had to abandon more than a dozen corpses before retreating again. The tank's artillery, while repelling the Soviet border guard's frontal attack, also brought back the familiar rhythm of the German infantry, who had been beaten and lost dozens of soldiers, and the French Fries Lord once again entered the brink of death. Bidman/12.9/assault soldier, light infantry, /MP-38, finally, the record has been corrected. However, there was only a moment of joy, and the French Fries gentleman discovered from the small map that there were already less than 10 small blue dots left, which were originally nearly 30. Skipping the brink of death perspective and immediately entering the birds that I deployment interface, I also found that German tanks formed a pincer line, gripping the entire border outpost. The already shaken position struggle bar has become as solid as a rock. Damn it, it's not about martial arts. Isn't it pure infantry combat? Why did you brush so many tanks? The French Fries gentleman, who realized that things were not going well, could only use a game perspective to make his mouth stink. At the same time, they quickly deployed their positions and the vehicle destroyer once again came out, wanting to save them. They had just cooperated with each other and had been treated as remnants of the Soviet Border Defense Army as their game buddies. Eat my big hand grenade flax. Reborn at the end of the air defense trench, the French Fries Lord forcefully swung out the anti-tank bound grenade, then touched the stinger and began to charge with his head buried. This crazy move directly put the German army's 2-4 tanks behind them in an awkward situation. The turret, which originally took into account friendly forces and aimed towards both sides to guard the flanks in a combat formation, almost happened to be in the opposite direction of the direction of the French Fry Lord. On the turret, the captain heard the strange cry of the French Fry Lord before directing the turn, giving him a few golden seconds. It made up for the problem of French Fry's Lord still not having much accuracy in the grenade, which only forced the German commander into the turret and failed to directly hit the tank. And with the help of a universal ammunition box, he gave the opportunity to successfully destroy a Type 4 tank in the 2nd platoon of Chibabi Mother Pinch Cow. Upon hearing another explosion from the rear, the German infantry, who had already undergone conditioned reflexes, immediately spotted the French Fries Lord charging towards another 4 tank. Fantasy Tank 2nd Company's Chips Lord is once again sent to the death screen. Destroy vehicle plus 100 attack kill plus 150 support team plus 200. Looking up at the start of scoring on the screen, Mr. French Fries couldn't be happy at all. Bidman/12.10/support soldier, machine gunner, /MG-42, gone, it's still too difficult for infantry to fight tanks. I don't know, On the real battlefield, the success rate of infantry anti-tank on foot is extremely low under field conditions, and the French Fries Lord passively completes the Versailles speech. From a dying perspective, I saw the four tank turning its turret and firing a single shot towards the location where I had climbed out of the air defense trench. I knew that my rebirth beacon was gone, and the French Fries Lord let out a mournful cry. What should I do? The French Fries Lord, who was not disappointed by his wish to have another bottle, looked at the remaining members of the Soviet border defense forces who were completely surrounded in the bird's eye view of the deployment, unable to redeploy as members of the team. The nearest deployable point was also far away from the Soviet defense fortifications, and had already given up treatment. The remaining members of the Soviet border defense team, who had been trapped by several tanks on the other side, were preparing for the final charge. Facing one side were already suppressed German infantry, and the other side were coaxial machine guns torn apart by tank fire. A few people who knew it was difficult to turn back were preparing to charge towards the German infantry for close combat, in order to avoid the firepower of German tanks and take away more enemies. Throwing the final grenade, just as Soviet soldiers were crawling and preparing to charge, several smoke bombs suddenly exploded on the battlefield. Digging 3 feet deeper from the field warehouse, several discarded 37mm grenade launchers and some supporting ammunition were dug out. The political commissar of the Border Defense Army, along with over 100 new recruits from the labor camp, finally arrived to provide support. A wave of surprise attacks successfully disrupted the German encirclement plan and rescued the remaining Soviet troops under the cover of smoke bombs. I'll go, it turns out it can all be opened. I witnessed a large number of small blue dots suddenly flashing on the deployment interface, forming an anti-encirclement force, and attacked the German French Fries Lord, immediately reigniting the fighting spirit. My brothers are waiting for me, and I will go find the Jade Emperor to bring some reinforcements. As I have never found the deployment method of the vehicle, I choose to deploy the rebirth point that appears behind the Soviet defense position again. Start searching for the desired fixed weapon points by placing a map of different sizes. Chapter 8. Old Cannons and Veterans. You are listening at novelfull.audio. In the spider web-like trenches displayed on the mini-map, I quickly discovered two anti-tank gun marked French fries next to the central supply point, which made me very excited. Isn't the rescue coming now? Sprint all the way and rush towards the marked point. French fries, who lacked knowledge of various types of infantry engineering, completely failed to realize what it meant to have only two anti-tank guns arranged behind the front line, with no firing range, and even adjacent to each other, in a trench of this size. Sergeant Ivan, who had already heard the sound of artillery in the direction of 178 Heights, and the remaining 9-man Soviet border guard, were very nervous at the moment. The captain took away most of the border soldiers who survived the raid, and the political commissar took away most of the recruited labor camps. Now this position, which should have had an entire infantry battalion of 500.600 people stationed, is left with only 9 trained soldiers and around 20 newly armed laborers, and there is a serious lack of heavy weapons that should have been assigned here, let alone temporarily hopeless superior support. The sound of cannons, like heavy hammers, hit every Soviet border soldier crawling in the front scattered soldier pit. At this moment, they could only pray, praying for something to save them. Sergeant Ivan, Sergeant Ivan. A laborer, without any concealment, climbed out of the trench and ran straight towards the foxhole covered by Ivan. Comrade Tredykov, who was ordered back by the captain, has repaired those two old guns, 37mm 1930, 1.K, anti-tank guns. We are now looking for someone to push the guns. What? Ivan, who was continuously controlled by the sound of tank gunfire, grabbed a life-saving straw. Although two guns and shells with a total of less than one base, as any rational person knows, cannot stop large-scale tank assaults, at this moment these two guns have become the backbone of the entire position. Let's go, push the cannons, Ivan instructed a soldier to continue monitoring the front line, quickly leading the others along the traffic trench towards the temporary field warehouse, without paying any attention to the fact that there was never a person named Tredykov at the border outpost here. The system had intervened to modify the relevant personnel's memory. A few minutes ago, Mr. Potato finally found the anti-tank gun marked on the mini-map when he touched a huge civil bunker. He was then shocked by the shape of the anti-tank gun. Mr. Potato could swear to the Bug River with his basic knowledge of artillery, which could only be called anti-tank gun parts. Fortunately, I have a universal hammer. Switching the equipment to a hand hammer, Jun Chang breathed a sigh of relief as he clearly saw two constructible logos on the ground parts. Approaching, switch the wrench shape with the hammer, once, twice build plus 10 build plus 10, who is it? As the Frenchman tinkled and repaired two cannons, a person in an ill-fitting khaki military uniform finally found the Frenchman and quickly raised his rifle towards him. You raise your hand, It turns out it's Comrade Tredykov. You can even repair artillery. The Soviet laborer, who could see the face of the French fries king, put down his trembling rifle again, system intervention memory modification. Sigh, you happen to go find someone to push the cannon. The sudden appearance of friendly forces provides a new solution for the worried problem of the French fries lord. Originally, these two cannons that he had repaired in the void looked small, but when he pushed them himself, they were very heavy and could not move at all. It seemed that they had to be towed by vehicles like in the game to move. For the first time, realizing that the built-in system doesn't seem to be all the advantages, the French fry owner can only hope that with more people, they can push it forward. Soon, the border soldiers led by Ivan arrived here. Looking at the two newly produced cannons, Ivan didn't think there was any problem at all and immediately called everyone to start pushing the cannons. Watching several Soviet soldiers, pulling the traction rope and pushing the gun rack, the artillery was successfully moved, and the French fries gentlemen also relaxed and joined the ranks of pushing the artillery. After more than 10 minutes, the artillery was finally pushed to the position that had just been disguised again by the workers. Do any of you know how to fire? Just as everyone seemed to have found the key to victory and the corners of their mouths began to rise, an untimely voice came from the group of laborers gathered to watch the cannons. The air suddenly froze, and there was no firing in the training program for the border troops. Ivan, who was preparing to plan his artillery shells, froze. I can. Mr. French Fries thought that firing a gun would be like in a game, just press E to aim and fire, so he immediately jumped out to brush his presence. But we have two cannons, right? Ivan, who had no doubt that the French Fries Lord would really fire, looked around at the laborers as if trying to find the person who shook the morale of the army. I can do it too, I used to be an artillery soldier before. The voice just now paused for a moment, as if bringing back my soul. Then a man wearing a clearly short military uniform walked out from behind the laborer, with a scruffy beard, prominent white hair at the temples, and even a small belly. Do you have anything to prove? Ivan looked up and down at the person. Precious shells cannot be wasted by those who cannot fire. Here you are, the man carefully took out a medal from the inside of his clothes and handed it to Ivan. Ivan knows this medal, it is a first-class George medal, and the Golden Cross has been highly reflected by the grinding wheel. It is a medal awarded to brave soldiers or non-commissioned officers during the Tsarist era. This man used to be a white soldier. If you want to arrest me now, then do it. The man continued as if relieved, no, the Soviets welcome all soldiers willing to defend their homeland. This gun is under your command, you guys cooperate with him. Ivan returned the medal to the man and instructed several laborers to cooperate with him. All right, now let's all return to our positions. The Soviet needs us to continue carrying out the mission. While gaining valuable anti-tank capabilities in the rear defense positions. 178 meters high underground, the political commissar of the Soviet Border Army, who had just temporarily shaken off German tanks and infantry with the help of bushes and smoke bombs, recounted the troops following him. The captain of the Border Defense Army has died, leaving only 6 people, each with injuries, and only 33 laborers left. I am well aware of the powerlessness of my pure infantry to confront the German tank forces. The political commissar of the Border Defense Army had to start thinking about how to continue the battle. It's obvious that rushing and hitting are not enough. Let's go back first. The ultimately helpless Soviet political commissar had to admit that the current troops were likely unable to complete the planned tasks and had to temporarily lead the remaining soldiers back to the defense fortifications. And I hope the messenger sent a few hours ago can find his superior. Otherwise, he would have to lead the remaining soldiers to defend the national defense positions. Chapter 9. Unknown Resistance War. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Despite feeling uneasy about the numerous storms and intelligence on the front line late at night on June 21, Zhukov successfully urged Stalin to make a decision and began the codenamed Storm Border Cover Plan. But the relevant instructions were not issued to the Western Special Military Region until 0:45 a.m. on the 22nd, and it was not until 2:30 a.m. that they reached various group armies and fortification areas. This means that the Soviet army on the entire border line has no time to engage in any organized defensive operations. So on the 500-mile-long Bug River, all the surprise attack plans by the German army to seize the bridge over the river were unsuccessful. Similarly, the operation of setting up emergency bridges for forced crossing has also been successful. The entire 2nd Armored Group was able to use these bridges to launch a deep assault while the Soviet command headquarters were still in chaos, and everything went smoothly except for the slightly unexpected Corden area. Under the command of Sergeant Ivan, 43 Soviet soldiers, including Chips Lord, occupied 2 anti-tank support points in the deep defense fortifications of Corden, intending to engage in a blockade that was destined to be unknown and had no chance of victory. On June 22, 41, at 7:18 a.m., the sky had already brightened and the entire Soviet position had lost cover in the darkness. After reinforcing the anti-tank positions, the French Fries Lord and several border soldiers went again to the scattered soldier pit in front of the position to investigate the direction of 178 Highlands. Damn it, the mini-map will only follow the war zone, the enraged Mr. Potato realized that after redeploying here, the system had already determined that the previous area was lost, and the mini-map automatically changed to display the current defense fortifications, completely unaware of the areas previously fought and the situation of the Soviet army. The 2 occupation points currently displayed were occupied by Ivan, in order to maximize the firepower of only 2 artillery pieces, who led people to occupy the southernmost and northernmost of the original 5 anti-tank support points. Chips June is in the north, point A, and Sergeant Ivan is in the south, point B. Someone ahead. A border soldier was the first to notice a figure appearing in the bushes ahead. The tattered khaki military uniform indicates the identity of the visitor. Comrade political commissar ordered us to hold on to this place and not retreat at all. The person immediately shouted when he noticed the border soldiers who had actively reached out and gestured. Then he fell head-on. 2 minutes later, the Soviet soldiers, covered in bloodstains, were carried back to the support point. They regained consciousness and conveyed the news of the front line to Mr. French Fries in a weak voice. The remaining soldiers led by the political commissar of the Border Defense Army were unable to successfully escape the pursuit of German infantry and tanks, and could only resist on the spot, hoping to buy more defense time here. Considering the speed difference between the legs and the tracks, the Germans should be coming soon. Soon, the smoke and dust carried by the tank on the ground appeared in the distant bushes. All concealed, only when hearing the anti-tank gun fire can you shoot. Sergeant Ivan's messenger conveyed the order to the support point where Mr. Chips was located. Knowing that the tank was approaching, Mr. Potato quickly withdrew from his gun position along the foxhole. He had just instructed a soldier to open the anti-tank ammunition box and take out a shell before being surprised to find it. What about the operation prompt? Why can't I long press E to enter the vehicle? Taking the shell and looking at the anti-tank gun, leveling machine, Highland machine, sight, bolt, and fire rope, the potato chip king with a bewildered expression on his face, the CPU quickly burned and said, how can I shoot this damn gun? I can't do it. Fortunately, the Soviet Border Defense Forces, who watched as Chip's June took over the shell without any action, had already been modified by the system. Otherwise, seeing Chip's June in a daze might have already determined that Chip's June wouldn't be firing. Everyone go command those new recruits, don't let them shoot indiscriminately and expose their positions, let me operate the gun alone. Several soldiers heard the order without any questions and immediately went to execute it. Just as the last soldier left the gun position and headed towards the trench, the French fries finally saw the prompt in the head-up display to press and hold E to enter the vehicle. Immediately, the French fries lord possessed Superman in the battlefield, and the ammunition was loaded and aimed together to synthesize. The cannon swayed up, down, left, and right at an unexpected speed. Fortunately, game mode, start. After successfully overclocking the CPU, the potato chip lord finally realized the first rule of his system by combining the game's operations with his previous experience of moving anti-tank guns. Operations that violate reality can only take effect and no one else is paying attention. Quickly, the first German 4 tank appeared in the sight of the French fries lord, who aimed with faith. The French fries lord immediately manipulated his focus to roughly point towards this tank. According to the plan previously agreed upon with the White Army veteran, in order to ensure that these two old cannons can effectively attack, they will adopt the method of firing first by the veteran, then by the French fries lord, and collectively gathering a tank to fire. As for why the French fries lord did not fire first, he would not say that he could only rely on luck to hit a fixed target in the black history of shooting on the beach of Iwo Jima. The second and third tanks quickly appeared in a group of 10 German tanks, forming a formation of two in front and one behind, heading towards the national defense positions. The six tanks in front are already firing towards the suspected firepower point, followed closely by German infantry in a scattered formation. 800m, 700m. The German army was like a black cloud, pressing against the Soviet defense line. This brewing tsunami seemed to be able to break through the weak defense of the Soviet army in just 1 second. Without much military knowledge, as a defender for the first time, I saw the war machine sweeping across Europe and launched a complete corner towards myself. I just feel like time has come to a stop. Why haven't you opened fire yet? Although his gamified body doesn't tremble or sweat, as a peaceful person in a world that he considers to be a game, Chip's June experienced the pressure of war for the first time. Previously, it was either a surprise attack or a surprise attack, mainly the latter, either a mindless charge or on the way to a mindless charge, where there were no other teammates around, but the German army was not openly pressing on the opposite side. Coupled with the AR visual enhancement in front of him, like in the game, Chip's lord had never felt this way before. This pressure forced the French fry lord to recall the image of his previous death in action. This may be true, the French fries gentleman came up with this sentence for no reason. Bang! A cannon shot and exploded a spark on the front German 4, shattering two pieces of side armor. However, the tank only paused for a moment before continuing forward, and the shells of the White Army veterans were bounced off. Both sides quickly began a large dot-scale exchange of fire, and several MG-42 shells from the German rear immediately covered the anti-tank support points where the White Army veterans were located. The shells of the German mortar also landed on the roof of the newly reinforced anti-tank support point, causing countless pieces of soil to shake off. The near miss of the 75mm high explosive shell of Tank 4 was even more direct, with the blasted debris like hail passing through the bunker firing port and hitting the anti-tank gun shield, producing various noises. The appearance of the climax of the battlefield symphony pulled the French fry lord out of his almost breathless stillness, aiming and firing the god of luck favored the Chip's lord. The 4 tank, which had just flown a shell, was hit by the Chip's lord and broke its tracks, making it unable to move. Hit plus 30 damage track plus 78 defense bonus plus 100. The appearance of the head-up display has reactivated the French Fry King. This is war. No, this is a game. Mr. French Fries went crazy, no longer thinking about any shooting plans, nor considering the situation where Ivan had once instructed him to only have 20 shells. He only focused on mechanical loading and firing, not just targeting tanks, but also targeting all German targets in his field of vision. Fired a frenzied cannon, unleashing a rate of fire that did not belong to it. Although the chip's lord no longer entered the aiming interface, he only used the aiming center to shoot roughly, which can be said to be not very accurate, but the quantity filled everything. Only 20 shells. What is that? Battlefield Superman's artillery, with unlimited shells that never overheat. The French Fry's lord fired a cannon that unleashed the aura of an artillery company, causing the German offensive to come to a sudden halt. But the German army, which had been attacked multiple times since the early hours of the morning, had put aside its initial disdain for the Soviet army. Soon, the German division's heavy artillery on the opposite bank of the Bug River began to roar again. On the mini-map, the scattered 30 or so small blue dots quickly turned into forks, and the artillery used by the White Army veterans changed from blue to unmanned white. Only the potato chip lord, with his data-driven body and data-driven gun shield, stood tall in the artillery fire, relying on his ability to be destroyed only by direct hits from regional artillery, continuing to roar towards the German direction. But the firing range of the artillery was ultimately limited, and soon French Fries were once again sent to the battlefield by German engineers using explosives. Bidman/34.11/support-core/engineer/adhesive-explosives this time, with no intention of paying attention to the bonus points of the death screen and the head-up display screen crash. Data June was just waiting for the near-death perspective to end. The deployment interface went black, and the countdown to deploying again was 30. 29, and the countdown began again. Even with hanging field artillery, it was impossible to stop the German main armor division from accumulating breakthrough operations for a long time, even if it was only a secondary direction for German breakthroughs, even if it was only a small part of it. Chapter 10. Exploring the Open Field with a Face. You are listening at NovelFull.audio. Soviet greetings, Comrade Tredykov, Private. Due to some minor frictions in Western Europe, the Soviet Union demanded an increase in the overall combat readiness level of the army. Considering that you are a member of the elite border defense force of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, we now order you to defend the Bug River and Hayam River section, training order number 5 of the First Special Motorized French Fries Brigade. Once again, the familiar plot prompts were refreshed, and the countdown was reset to zero. The still confused French Fries Lord was deployed in the border defense fortification of the 56th Infantry Division of the German Southern Army Group. I didn't pay attention to wonder why I was guarding the Bug River again, nor did I notice that the head-up display was still at 3.10 on June 22, 41, this familiar time. Mr. French Fries, holding a PPD submachine gun in his hand, looked blankly across the river from the border checkpoint. This time, the French Fries Lord was not ambushed, or rather, he was no longer ambushed. At 3.15, German artillery on the other side of the river rang out on time. The difference is that the Soviet positions here were almost completely understood by the German Air Force reconnaissance. The artillery used as a knocking brick almost accurately smashed all Soviet support points. Death interface bidman slash 34.12 slash scout, slash area artillery from a dying perspective, the French Fry Lord looked at the occasional explosion of shells nearby and spat out a sentence, "It really doesn't seem like a game." German soldiers crossed the river with almost no casualties and effortlessly advanced 15 kilometers deep through local defense fortifications. Once again, the deployment interface went black, facing the countdown to deploying again. This is a game. This is not a game. No, I have to go home. The French Fry King regained his spiritual support. The performance of the Soviet army on the entire Bug River defense line was similar to that of the French Fries Lord in a confused state. The entire border defense force was caught off guard by a German thug, a thug that the Soviet army should have been prepared for. This resulted in the successful capture of bridges and the construction of emergency bridges by the German army on the 800-kilometer long Bug River, and the Central Army Group's deep assault on the Brest area was almost all smooth. Even in some areas, due to Stalin's intention to delay the Soviet-German war as much as possible, he believed that the Soviet Red Army, which was not yet ready to face the German army, was trying to complete the reform of its organization and update its equipment, and had been implementing a compromise strategy that was almost appeasement. Allowing the German Air Force reconnaissance planes to fly recklessly across the border for reconnaissance, these planes even reached as far as the front lines of Minsk and Smolensk. Make the local border troops behave like they are reaching out to get stuck by the German army. Unfortunately, on the first day of the war, the chaos in the Soviet command system prevented the border troops along this route from having the opportunity to regain the backbone of the battle, just like the French Fries Lord who could come back together again. So although these tens of thousands of border troops were led by the Soviet Ministry of Internal Affairs, well-trained, and extremely tenacious in combat spirit. However, more than half of the losses were still incurred within the first few hours of the war, and they were completely wiped out in less than a week thereafter. Soviet greetings, Comrade Tredykov, Private. Due to some minor frictions in Western Europe, the Soviet Union demanded an increase in the overall combat readiness level of the army. Considering that you are a member of the elite border defense force of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, we now order you to defend the Sang River section in the northern part of Przemysl, Training Order No. 6 of the 1st Special Motorized French Fries Brigade. The Potato Chip Lord, who stood up spiritually, once again saw the familiar plot prompts, noticed the changes in the landmark given by the command, and thought of Sang River. The Soviet-German border is very long, it seems that I have changed to another place. The countdown to redeployment has ended. This time, Mr. French Fries appeared at a customs checkpoint on the Soviet side of the San River Railway Bridge in Ledimno. Immediately, Mr. French Fries realized that there were more Soviet border guards stationed at the checkpoint here than on the banks of the Bug River. This was due to the Soviet General Staff's pre-war assessment of the German main attack direction. The German army will mainly attack from the southern front to seize the grain-producing areas of Ukraine and the oil-producing areas of the Caucasus region, which are more important for the wartime economy. Therefore, unlike the Western Front, the Soviet Southwest Front here has better combat readiness and a more complete border warning system. This means that the German raid on the southern front is not destined to be too easy. Head-up display. June 22, 41-3.15. While patrolling the front line of customs with the Soviet border defense team, Mr. French Fries watched as time once again reached a moment of fate. The German artillery began to roar. The Soviet border troops, who quickly recovered from the panic, immediately realized the focus of the German attack. A railway bridge over the Sang River. Therefore, although the German assault team had launched a surprise attack just before the artillery preparations, they successfully took control of the railway bridge. The Soviet border defense forces located at the customs checkpoint also launched a counterattack at almost the same time. Faced with the pincer attacks of nearly 2,000 German assault battalions, the Soviet border defense forces showed unexpected resilience. At the moment when the gunfire started, Mr. Potato immediately slid a shovel into the foxhole he had already observed, and set up the DP machine gun he had specially replaced on the deployment interface, with the muzzle pointing towards the direction of the railway bridge. As for why he disregarded the other parts of the riverbank, Mr. Potato can only say that the railway bridge is defense point A represented on the mini-map, and this point was already displayed as occupied when he first deployed it. The Soviet border troops, who were almost as fast as the French Fries Lord, immediately launched a battle formation towards the direction of the railway bridge. I couldn't help but give the Frenchman a thumbs up on his teammates' level this time. Soon, the figure of German infantry appeared on the edge of a small forest on the Soviet side that covered the railway bridge. Mr. French Fries immediately opened fire and easily knocked down the German soldier charging towards the outermost side. Kill plus 100 defensive kill plus 150 Mr. Potato continued to fire, and the submachine guns of the Soviet Border Patrol quickly rang out. Without anticipating the reaction speed of the Soviet Army, the German assault team's elite group was quickly knocked down. Xie Miao raised the alarm. Sergeant Demetrius, the captain of the Soviet patrol team, shouted to a soldier. Others, come with me. The soldier whose name was called immediately ran to the emergency phone in the shelter of the customs checkpoint, which was a direct call to the local border defense brigade. Meanwhile, Chips Lord, along with Sergeant Demetrius and 10 other Soviet border guards, conducted reconnaissance along the railway ditch towards the direction of the railway bridge. While the Soviet Border Defense Battalion was fully awakened by a phone call, the German Assault Battalion, which had not been detected upstream and downstream of the railway bridge, had successfully surrounded both sides of the Soviet garrison due to the Soviet Border Patrol's compliance with restraint orders, deliberately reducing the number of rounds and extending the patrol interval. The Soviet patrol team, who could already see the railway bridge through the cracks in the trees, slowed down under the leadership of Sergeant Demetrius. Suddenly, Sergeant raised his left hand and clenched his fist to pull down. The 10 soldiers who followed immediately lay down and hid on both sides of the ditch. The French Fries Lord, who did not know the Soviet Army's combat sign language, had to react slowly and rushed out of the edge of the small forest with a shovel before lying down. Lie down. The German gunfire erupted. Chips Lord has entered the death screen bid man slash 35.12 slash assault soldier, light infantry, slash MP40 from a dying perspective. Mr. French Fries finally understood why the customs checkpoint was so far away from the riverbank towards the railway bridge. It turned out that the ground on both sides of the riverbank was as flat as a pancake, with no trees, no ravines, and no cover for infantry to hide. Therefore, the Soviet Army did not set up positions on the railway bridge, but set up customs checkpoints behind a small forest that was a long distance from the railway bridge. Because of this, the German advance assault remained silent, and the vanguard troops were further away from the rear army, without making a clear response to the previous exchange of fire between the two sides. Until now, the French Fries Lord rushed out of the shelter of the forest and landed on the German M35 helmet. The German army immediately unleashed their maximum firepower and began charging, intending to rush through this open area in the shortest possible time. Staff Sergeant Demetrius, who didn't care about cursing the French Fries Lord's father, had no choice but to command the Soviet patrol team to fully open fire. The exchange of fire between the two sides reached a white heat at the beginning. The German side had firepower advantages but lacked cover, while the Soviet side, although relying on trees and grass, had a hidden advantage, was weak. A bloody battle that cannot be avoided unfolds here.